1972, an invitation to consider a concert tour of Romania was extended to the Syosset High School band by the ambassador of the Socialist Republic of Romania. This tour would come under the auspices of the Ambassadors for Friendship program of the American Council for Nationalities Service. The contemplated trip would encompass 2 weeks in 6 cities featuring 7 formal presentations. At the first meeting of parents and band members to consider this project, Dr. Walter Yannette, our high school principal, welcomed Dr. Tornavano, director of tourism for Romania, who arrived in Syosset to personally invite the band to visit his country. Following approval of parents and the Syosset Board of Education, the tour dates were set as February 8th through 22nd, 1973, to coincide partially with the normal midwinter vacation. Although each parent was encouraged to guarantee 50% of the total cost of $440 per student, the Band Parents Association pledged that no student would be precluded from going for lack of financial commitment. The participating group would include all members of the concert band, the jazz band, and the twirling squad, a total of 90 performers and 8 chaperones. All chaperones were to be professional school personnel.
The band was now faced with the seemingly impossible task of raising the unpledged $25,000 of the total cost of $45,000. Due to the extraordinary efforts of the Syosset High School Band Parents Organization, band members, and school personnel, these funds were raised. 3 months later, our tour was financially secured, and on January 8th, we paid our 50% deposit. Local publicity attracted major newspaper coverage, culminating in the assignment by Newsday of reporter Ed Lowe to accompany the band.
In addition to the arduous fundraising activities, the band, under conductor James Donnelly, was involved in intensive rehearsals. The program would include representative American band music, while the jazz band unit, led by director Leonard Motisi, chose popular and familiar music from the past 4 decades. Numerous meetings were held with parents, students, and chaperones to explain the formalities of foreign travel, passport applications, visas, and other essentials. Extensive orientation was necessary concerning customs, mores, laws, and the details of travel etiquette. On tour, we discovered many customs which were strange and new to our students. There was often a long wait for dessert and coffee, as is the Romanian style. The chaperones were more patient than the students. Although it is not an American custom to serve wine to students, the band soon learned to enjoy this festive aspect of Romanian dining. It became immediately apparent that sensible packing was essential. Suitable accoutrements for normal health maintenance were made available at all times. Infinite care in packing all audio equipment and instruments, although consuming a tremendous amount of thought and time, facilitated security and safety of instruments in transit and in setting up for performances. In fact, one cannot overprepare. All heavy and bulky instruments had to be pre-shipped, necessitating accurate measurements to the exact cubic centimeter and kilogram of 36 pieces of equipment. Differences in electrical voltage required battery-operated amplifiers and tape recorders. 90 uniforms were individually packed and bulk shipped in three custom-made cartons. Special timpani crates were rented. Spare supplies and parts were unavailable in Romania, requiring the band to be totally self-sufficient in this respect. In retrospect, a closer liaison with the Romanian tourist office would have surmounted much of the red tape that we encountered when trying to repossess these pre-shipped instruments in Bucharest.
Our students said their farewells at the school prior to our departure at Kennedy Airport. The bandsmen would meet their parents at a school reception upon their return 2 weeks later. In this manner, families were actively discouraged from traveling to the airport for either departure or return, thus establishing the unity of the group from the outset. Upon arrival in Bucharest, the band met their English-speaking student guides and the Mercedes-built Setrip touring buses that would be their home on wheels. Hotel accommodations varied from ultra-modern to older yet comfortable rooms. Facilities generally included double rooms, mostly with private baths and pleasant clean surroundings. Concert halls ranged from modern, spacious, acoustical marvels to more traditional school auditoriums.
Setting up and breaking down for each concert required the complete cooperation of the entire band, many times while audiences were patiently waiting for the concert to begin. By necessity, students became adept at unpacking and tuning in a matter of minutes, including giving most concerts without sufficient warm-up. Audiences were usually standing room only, with young audiences generally more demonstratively appreciative than more mature ones. The love affair between our students and the Romanian audiences was instantaneous.
I loved the experience of concerts. I felt like a superstar or something. I was never so proud of my uniform or of a group of people from my high school.
Despite exhaustion, strangeness of the surroundings, and insufficient setup time, the band consistently outplayed itself. On two occasions, we were treated to reciprocal performances of outstanding caliber. Neither words nor our audio equipment can capture the feeling of electricity that permeated our entire band while enjoying these Romanian performances. During our second concert in Bucharest at Michael the Brave High School, we heard a most magnificent a cappella choir present a program in seven languages. The choir concluded with a charming rendition of Jingle Bells in beautifully enunciated English. Jingle bell, 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 jingle bell. That they did this in English obviously delighted them, as it did our kids. In each situation, the best was yet to come. The mingling of students with each other. We were truly ambassadors for friendship. In a sense, this is what it was all about. Young people eagerly moving about and somehow communicating and indicating warmth and friendship toward each other. The result was pure joy.
Our stay in Romania was certainly not all work. Our sightseeing included a tour of Dracula's castle, an imposing fortress built to defend against Turkish invaders, visits to churches which reflected the Byzantine influence in art and architecture, museums which gave us insights into the history and lifestyle of the early Dacian inhabitants. And government buildings, which demonstrated by their very location in proximity, the traditionally close church-state relationship. For entertainment, we enjoyed a night at the State Opera House, where we were treated to a Romanian ballet production of Tchaikovsky's Sleeping Beauty. We were guests at several festive dinners, which included typical Romanian folk dancing and entertainment. A stop at the village of Corte de Argeș gave us the opportunity to get some much-needed rest at mid-tour. Between games of soccer with Romanian children and some needed sleep, we also had our first and only chance to rehearse. The day culminated with a surprise birthday party for the seven bandsmen whose birthdays occurred during the tour. So far from home, this typically American scene brought us closer together as a family of 100.
I'll never forget my 16th birthday. How many people can say they spent their 16th birthday in Romania with such great people? Music was provided by our own rock group, while our Romanian guides were presented with Syosset High School jackets.
When asked how she was enjoying the evening, one of our flutists remarked,
"This is great! I'm meeting kids from the far reaches of the band!"
A particularly unique experience was an overnight stay with individual families in the peasant village of Lorești. Despite the cultural barriers and the fact that our hosts spoke no English, as well as the initial apprehension of the band members who arrived directly from a concert in full uniform, the experience was a highlight of the tour. We were welcomed as honorary members of the village by their priest, Father Shushiano Stelian, who greeted us with the traditional bread, plum brandy, and a kiss on both cheeks. His sincere warmth and concern for our well-being established the pattern in all homes where the band slept. We also enjoyed the first home-cooked meal since our arrival in Romania. The following morning, Father Stelian took us on a guided tour of his village church and willingly posed in his majestic vestments to the delight of us all. Despite the primitive facilities and the natural fear of the unknown, the students, nonetheless, were most appreciative of the opportunity to share family life in such a real situation. The buses departed for the tour culmination, a four-day stay at the internationally famous ski resort of Poiana Brașov. We presented three more concerts in nearby cities using the beautiful surroundings of this resort as a base to provide a beautiful Romanian winter setting.
The impact of the trip on our band members exceeded our greatest expectations. The high level of performance was not only sustained, but improved with each concert. The emotional playing of the Star Spangled Banner reflected the true meaning of our national anthem from the first concert. While communication was easily established through music, the daily relations with the Romanian people provided a different challenge.
The language barrier itself presented a problem that I felt was the most exciting to overcome. If by some means French, Spanish, a little Romanian or hand sign language, I could make myself understood or understand someone else, then think how much better you can come to truly understand the people and their feelings.
The most significant outcome of this close personal contact among bandsmen and chaperones under hectic and exciting conditions was the genuine love we developed for each other.
I loved it. I'd do it again anytime. I didn't know I belonged to such a great group of people.
One thing I did notice is how everyone, not only the band members, but the chaperones too, found a direct closeness to one another and a friendliness that I don't believe has ever been found in such a large group of high school kids and teachers.
I don't think I'll ever experience this again. We gave each other the most precious gift a person can give, our love.
An acceptance of things different and an appreciation of other cultures is best exemplified by one of our students in a letter to the editor of Newsday.
I consider myself extremely fortunate to participate in such a once-in-a-lifetime event. From this experience, I realize that it is not ideologies or governments or political intrigue that counts, but people, flesh and blood human beings. Perhaps if more people had the opportunity to observe this reality, war and hate could finally be erased from the face of this earth.